Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Welcome to Cowboys Stadium in Arlington. It's time for football and the kickoff classic. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. And with that, we kick off our season. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 31. Tackle made right around the 42-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Complete. He's hammered. Gets to around the 42.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
On the give. And he shoved out of bounds at the 21. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
Anderson, the intended receiver on the play. That brings him second and goal.
This is the eighth drive.
Tight, double tight. Three down. Watch 48.
Touchdown, Wisconsin. Great-looking touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
And he converts the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 76-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 7-0. Wisconsin is lining up to kick this one off. Lawson from the two. Kirk, one of the top backs in the country we get a chance to see today. Sims' big playability makes him a threat to score really anytime he touches.
I love this guy. And let's not forget about his big offensive line. This is a group that really prides themselves in opening up some huge holes for him. It's also going to be difficult to stop him and keep him out of the end zone because, you think about it, he's known for his big plays, the home run ability. So if you can limit those big plays, you got a shot at least at slowing him down.
And he gets the ball 25, 30 times a game, and he'll probably get that again today. From their own 26-yard line, second down. Pass, it out to the wideout, and he's got the first. And he's taken down around the 43-yard line. And he's going to be sacked.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 41-yard line. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. First down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
Might have been some early movement up front.
False start. Offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So we'll have first and 15 after the down at about the 49. Great. Only gets about a yard there on the option keeper.
That's the senior safety that made that tackle. Great job of providing run support from the secondary.
Down at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it third and three.
The 39-yard line. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Quick strike, and he drops it. They don't pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. The Sooners saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Wisconsin up 7 points.
He throws a dart to the right.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Intercepted. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing. Zips it to the back. At the 37. this one away. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Wisconsin is up seven. And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
He was going to squeeze that pass in, but the defensive back does a nice job to reach out and bat it away.
Right now, he wants to get this kick, change field position. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Fires it out. He's scrambling, and they get the sack.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Badgers. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Dumps it complete over the middle. And they make the stop at about the 15-yard line. Nothing doing for the offense, and it's fourth down.
They did a good job of not letting the offense get much going on that possession.
To punt. And he's tackled at the 45. So he managed to get a few yards on the run back.
Yeah, but so much traffic in the middle there, it really makes it tough to break free.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Wisconsin is up a score. Throws, falling back, and finds his man. And down he goes, right around the 32-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Your instincts tell you to go for the pick. You've got to make the best play you can, and sometimes it's just batting the ball away.
From the 26-yard line, it's third down. And he's tackled right away. Gets out to about the 18-yard line. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in.
Robinson was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it third and 9.
They'll line it up again on third down. Throws throws it to the outside.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Wisconsin can make the possession game with this field goal. And it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. Heading for the corner. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around midfield. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And it's almost picked off.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 50. He fires this one. It falls incomplete.
That brings us third and 10.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. He airs it out. He's hit and taken down.
This secondary better tighten it up and take a test drive.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. And he's immediately tackled. And they got him.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that? Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of it.
From the 10, second down.
That's what I do.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideout.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Man, they knocked it loose. Fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Right has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Williams fields it at the 2. Tackle made at the 21-yard line. Momentum's been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Wisconsin is up by a touchdown. Jacobs off the fake. Pass is caught. The defense lays him out. Tackle made at about the 35. Out here. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Randall gets about 4 yards on the play. From the 47-yard line, second down. Nice run there.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You've got an open man like this. Just step and deliver and make the throw.
Wisconsin up 7 points. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So we're looking at another third down here. That's a great tackle at the 38. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. One will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Steps out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. They hand it off, and he's taken down around the 26-yard line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Tight first half of football, and we head to the break. So the Badgers with a touchdown lead.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense and can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me. You're not going to throw it deep. And all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Just going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 18-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gets it out quickly. He's taken down at the 23.
Nelson makes the tackle at the 23-yard line. That makes it 7-6.
He's to the 40. Brought down at the 49-yard line.
That's a good 26 on the ball. First down.
Tackle at the 43-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. First down.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Number 54 on the tackle at the 31-yard line. That makes it 2nd and 2.
He tackles him for a loss.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. They're about 4 yards away here on 3rd down. They go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short.
Great job here in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Incomplete. Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense.
Great play there by the D. It's early in the season, but they showed they don't get rattled at all. I give them a lot of credit.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Wisconsin is up 7. Tackles him hard at the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, 3rd down. Makes his way to about the 42.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
And once again, they'll come to the line. Bird on 3rd down. The Sooners' running game just took a big hit. Their back went out earlier with that injury, and now they're telling he's not going to be able to return today. And he hits him hard at the 40. Miranda picks up about 5 yards on that hookup.
That makes it 4 inches.
Wisconsin is up a score. Quick throw, and they make the stop around the 10-yard line. Gets to about the 8-yard line. It. Going to the end zone. Touchdown for the tight end.
That's a positive for the passing game. It was absolutely the right call in that situation.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
He makes the PAT, a 10-play, 66-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30. Wisconsin's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and the linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Caught, and he's hit immediately.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
That's three down and one to go. Badgers lead it by 2 touchdowns. This very pivotal fourth quarter. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Tough throw on the run and caught. Well, they've got the lead and they come up with a big stop, and it looks like they're going to get the football back. Alston is the punter. They get this one off and it's a beauty. He's taken down at the 26-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
Second down.
knees to the 40. Makes it out to about the 3. And he's tackled right away. Decent run up the gut. And he is drilled at the 13-yard line. And that run got stuffed.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
Third down, 9 to go. Ball on the 13-yard line.
Here we go, D. Sam!
The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's up, and it's good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. One's incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. They come out in a 5-wide set. Makes the catch, and look out.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed.
Man left, man left. Go down.
And he's level at the 41-yard line. Bryant picks up around 5 yards with that catch.
That makes it
less than 3 minutes in the game. He goes out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. Quick pass. They'll bring him down at about the 35.
Nelson with the tackle at the 35-yard line. That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. caught with room to work. That's a great tackle at the 26. In the shotgun and right out. Slings it out there incomplete. This is the 10th play of this drive. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Fires it out. And they'll bring down behind the line. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Just over a minute left. He lets it go. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. Hits the PAT. An 11-play, 66-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just start right out of that defense.
They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. After a nice pickup, Randall gets 7 yards on the play. Oklahoma's going to use their first time out of the half here. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Straight run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
Taken down at the 35.
Well, that's a prime stop by the defense. You know, Brad, one of the things that all defensive coordinators always try to emphasize is their ability to stop offenses on third down. That is a big stop, and I think it could have a lot to do with the outcome of this football game.
And he's immediately tackled.
Personally, I don't know how many times I'd pass on fourth and short, but apparently these guys had the perfect play drawn up.
First and 10, ball on the 33-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. And this one's all wrapped up. So the Badgers take this game 20-10. EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.